We will, as human beings, always have differences. We need to learn to navigate through these differences. We need to learn to appreciate what the Almighty has bestowed upon us in terms of favor. Moments ago, we were told that the divorce rate is very high. Are we not prepared to talk things out? Are we not prepared to work things out? Are we not prepared to sacrifice? Are we not prepared to be loyal for the sake of one another and for the sake of the betterment of our own children, offspring, family members, humanity at large? Yes, divorce is permissible, but as a last resort. We need to firstly try our best to resolve matters. We need to try our best to speak about things, like I said earlier, sacrifice, communicate. If you're not prepared to communicate, how do you expect to resolve problems? If you're not prepared to compromise to a degree, how do you expect to resolve matters? My beloved sisters, my beloved brothers, it's important that when we select a spouse, we follow the instructions of the Almighty. We follow the guidelines of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. He tells us to look at character. He tells us to look at conduct. He tells us to look at connection with the Maker, known as the Deen, the Akhlaq. Sometimes we don't do that, and then later on we regret. People say, is it permissible for me to marry so and so? There may be permissibility, but is it really someone that your relationship will last with, that you will have a good understanding with, a person whose character and conduct will lead them to respecting you? We lack respect sometimes. We scream and yell at each other. If that is the case, how will the relationship work? We will not be able to solve a family matter if we do not speak respectfully, if we yell and scream, shout and swear. So remember, as a believer, that should not be one of your characteristics at all. Neither with family, nor with those who are not your family. No yelling and swearing and abusing. Unfortunately, it is happening on a daily basis. You have people who come into the home as a husband perhaps, and he thinks he has the full authority to say what he wants and do what he wants in a manner that he wishes, without bearing in mind that he owes answerability to Allah Almighty to begin with. You owe it to Allah. Are you not ashamed of how you speak in the house? Are you not ashamed of how, or the words that you utter? Are you not ashamed of your children watching the way you are handling their own mother, and vice versa? Because at times the men are complaining to us to say, you're always speaking about one side of the coin. My beloved brothers, you think we don't speak about the other side because you're not even prepared to listen to what we have to say. I usually say I have addressed both sides, but the men, what do? They listen to the first 2 minutes of your speech and then they turn it off and they feel they know better in a lot of cases, right? Then they accuse you of not having addressed the matter, but instead they are guilty of not listening. May Allah Almighty help us and guide us, bearing in mind I'm a man too. So if we're guilty of it, it's collective.